What's up, everybody? Welcome to Rogue Reviews. My name is Evan.
I'm Nolan.
And today we're doing the trailer reaction for The War for the Planet of the Apes. Dude, I loved one. I loved two.
This is one of my favorite franchises.
Is this
going
the finisher right here? Is this the last one?
They said there might be more beyond this, but for now, this is completing that trilogy. Like, it's always so special when a franchise gets to like that three mark.
I was so worried about these movies. Like, I really was, but I mean, James Franco and Andy Serkis. Franco and Serkis killed it. Like,
yeah.
they were the heart of that first movie.
And the second one's like almost better. Like, starting that movie without any dialogue and just having
so
the apes
good.
Signs. Like,
it was so good. And it's crazy the difference between the two, because you have like kind of the domestic feel of the first movie.
Mm-hmm.
Like, everything hasn't gone crazy yet. And
yeah.
The second movie, it's like, dude, we're in it. The third one looks even crazier. We have Woody Harrelson, right?
Yeah, as the villain, which, like, in that first trailer when he's just, like, got the face paint on coming for season, I'm like, that is perfect. Like, he can knock this out of the park.
We gotta watch it.
Yeah.
All right, so here we go.
He's a smart one, isn't he? What are you gonna name him? Does it look like just apes to you?
He saved our lives. He was remarkable.
I swear that the word circus does. He should get Oscars for this.
He did, right?
No.
You're him.
I thought he did.
There's this whole motion capture thing that's going on.
I did not start this war. I fight only to protect apes.
Human he definitely looked gets better sick. In this movie, too,
ape
than the last movie.
Get smart. Then human kill ape, but not me. I run.
There are times when it is necessary to abandon our humanity to save humanity.
They must pay. I will finish this. I've showed you mercy.
You talk about mercy? No matter what you say, eventually you'd replace us. That's the law of nature. So what would you have done?
What is the humans promise you? No matter what you do, you'll never be one of them. You are.
Together. We are the beginning. Apes together. Strong. We
are the beginning. Apes together. Strong.
Have you come
to save your apes?
I came for you.
Stoked.
So good.
That's a far away
July
deadline right there.
Oh man. That, like, if this movie hits, we are talking about one of the best trilogies of all time. Like, that goes up there with Lord of the Rings. That goes up there with, you know, Toy Story. Like,
pretty tall.
I mean, if it hits the way we hope, like, if it hits the way this trailer projects it to, like, because we, in these movies, we've seen Caesar, like, in the first movie, you know, he's with James Franco, you know, he's nice to humans. And even in the second movie, you know, he resents them a little more. And this movie is just when he breaks and becomes
mm-hmm.
that leader that...
They're adding so much more depth with having that ethics and political
yeah.
kind of like battle between. It's not just like apes versus humans. It,
yeah.
It's this whole debate on, you know, I'm life. I can think
mm-hmm.
like this whole battle between the two. But it's like, no, you're an animal. Well. You know what I'm, you know
yeah,
what I'm saying?
Yeah,
it's like the
yeah.
whole ethics part of it and the heart of it is in there and you feel for them. They really captured that
yeah.
you know, emotional aspect between the apes and the humans and seeing both sides of it. And, dude, I agree. They are killing it. Best trilogy up through Lord of the Rings and, like...
I mean, in the discussion, at least.
Right, right. You know? Now, don't get me wrong. There's nothing wrong with these movies to say otherwise. I mean, they're kind of like... They're kind of like that movie where it's like, hey, remember that movie? Oh, yeah, it was so good.
Yeah, you just forget how good they are.
Those sleeper hits. Yeah. You know, like, dude, they are really good. Like, I don't have any beef with any of them, really.
I think the second one is almost a perfect movie in my eyes. Like, if that came out in our review, I remember seeing that movie and just being, like, blown away. Like, I love the first one.
It's like Logan.
Yeah.
Where... The movie was exactly what it wanted to be, and it killed it.
Yeah.
And I'll give it to that. The second one was like that. The first one was definitely close. I think it was still kind of finding it, especially that story origin thing.
Yeah.
But once the second movie hit, it had that, you know, momentum.
Matt Reeves has such a good handle on this franchise. He knows exactly what he wants to do. And that's why when they announced him as, like, the Batman director that after Ben Affleck left, and, like, I was like, oh, my gosh, who are they going to get to direct
this?
So
this is the guy. Okay.
This is the guy that's
okay.
going to direct
we'll
this.
We'll see if he sticks around.
I think they will. I think he won the whole, like, he's going to get more creative control. Because today they just announced Josh Whedon is doing Batgirl.
I saw that.
Yeah, so, but, yeah, this trilogy, hopefully if this movie hits the way... You know, because sometimes that third movie can be the drop-off point where you're like, oh, man, like,
usually,
the Hobbit movie.
Usually it's the second movie that's kind of the downer, because then you're like...
Well, yeah, the downer totally, but, like, usually sometimes the third movie, like, doesn't
know
quite,
how to finish.
Yeah. Like the,
we've seen that before.
Yeah, the Hunger Games movies, you know, the third one was, like, the weakest and stuff. So I'm like, I just hope this movie hits that strong note.
Not like Hunger Games. More like Lord of the Rings.
Yeah,
where
exactly.
Return of the King just capped it. It was amazing.
Yeah, exactly.
Dude, I'm stoked for it. Action looks great. CGI, of course, it's up to par.
Yeah.
Andy Serkis kills it. He directed too, right? Or is he a secondary director?
He's a secondary director. He's done a lot of secondary directing on like the Lord of the Rings films. He was going to do a Jungle Book film for Warner Brothers, but then the Disney one got released and... That we haven't heard anything since then, which if they were smart, they would just can
that.
Yeah. So that I think they weren't expecting the Disney one to do what it did. So, but yeah, he's a guy that's going to just be legend by the time he hangs it up. Cause
he's
the pioneer of this mocap
industry. He has his own like studio.
Yeah.
Like he is the pioneer in this.
Yep.
So it's going to be amazing. Really excited about it. War for the Planet of the Apes. Dude, can't wait for July.
It's going to be a good month.
There it is, guys. Our trailer reaction for War for the Planet of the Apes. Leave a like if you like the video. Subscribe if you'd like to see more. And yeah, we'll catch you on the next trailer reaction. All right, guys. We'll see you next time.
See ya.